Current Affairs Bulletin for the week will be of immense help for the students preparing for different competitive exams. Current Affairs Headlines. National Sports Awards 2016 announced. Summer Olympics 2016 concluded at Rio de Janeiro. Urjit R. Patel appointed as 24th Governor of Reserve Bank of India. Indian badminton player PV Sindhu wins silver in women's singles badminton event at Rio Olympics. SBI board approved merger of 5 associate banks, BMB, with itself. Hindi author Sunita Jain conferred with 25th Vyas Samman Award. Kamal Hassan chosen for France's Chevalier d'Ordre, Arts de Lettres. 9th edition of Global Innovation Index 2016 released. Sakshi Malik named brand ambassador for Beti Bachao Beti Padhao campaign in Haryana. New World Wealth Report 2016 released. India stood at 7th position. Sania Mirza becomes world number 1 in ATP Women's Doubles Tennis Rankings. Forbes releases 6th annual list of the world's most innovative companies 2016. Abhinav Bindra to head NRAI Review Committee on Rio Debacle. Union Cabinet approves introduction of Surrogacy Regulation Bill 2016. Union Government launches Sugamya Pustakale, an e-library for persons with print disabilities. Current Affairs in Detail. National Sports Awards 2016 announced. PV Sindhu, Sakshi Malik, Jeetu Rai and Deepa Karmakar will get Rajiv Gandhi Khel Ratna Awards. 6 sports coaches will be honored with Dronacharya Awards. 15 sports persons, including Lalita Babar, were selected for Arjuna Awards. 3 sports persons, including athlete Sati Geetha, selected for Dhyanchand Award. Summer Olympics 2016 concluded at Rio de Janeiro. The Games saw participation of more than 11,000 athletes from 207 National Olympic Committees. It featured 28 Olympic sports, including rugby sevens and golf, which were added in 2009. The United States, with 46 gold medals, topped the medal table for the 5th time. Great Britain and China finished in 2nd and 3rd respectively. India, with 2 medals, stood at the 67th place. Urjit R. Patel appointed as 24th Governor of Reserve Bank of India. Patel will serve a tenure of 3 years with effect from 4th September 2016. He will succeed the present RBI Governor, Dr. Raghuram Rajan. At present, Patel is the Deputy Governor of RBI. With this appointment, he becomes the 8th Deputy Governor to be elevated as RBI's Governor. Indian badminton player PV Sindhu wins silver in women's singles badminton event at Rio Olympics. With this, Sindhu became the first Indian woman to clinch a silver medal in Olympics. She also became the 4th Indian to win silver at Olympics. Moreover, she became the 5th woman player from India to win a medal in the Olympics. Sindhu lost to Carolina Marin of Spain in the final by a score of 19-21, 21-12, 21-15. In her quarterfinal match, Sindhu defeated world number 2, Wong Hian, by 22-20, 21-19. SBI board approved merger of 5 associate banks, BMB, with itself. 5 associate banks will be merged with the SBI. Apart from associate banks, the Bharatiya Mahila Bank will be merged. The merged entity will have 22,500 branches and 58,000 ATMs. The merger will make SBI as one of the top 50 banks in the world. Hindi author Sunita Jain conferred with 25th Vyas Samman Award. She was awarded for her poetry collection Shama, published in 2008. In the collection, she portrays the fine emotions between poet Tulsidas and his wife Ratnavali. Fine language helped her to aptly convey sentiment of forgiveness between Tulsidas and his wife. She writes in both English and Hindi and has over 100 books to her credit. She was awarded with the Padma Shri in 2004. Kamal Hassan chosen for France's Chevalier L'Ordre Arts et Lettres. The distinction is in recognition of Hassan's high level of artistic excellence. He is the second Tamil star after Sivaji Ganeshan to be honored with the award. The award is an Order of France established on 2 May 1957 by the Minister of Culture. The award's purpose is recognition of significant contributions to arts and literature. 9th edition of Global Innovation Index 2016 released. It was released jointly by Cornell University, INSEAD, and the World Intellectual Property Organization. The GII 2016 was based on the theme of winning with global innovation. India has ranked 66th in the index. The index is topped by Switzerland. Sakshi Malik named brand ambassador for Beti Bachao Beti Padhao campaign in Haryana. The announcement was made by Haryana Chief Minister Manohar Lal Khattar at Bahadurgarh. Besides, Malik was offered a class 2 level job in the state government. The Chief Minister also awarded her with 2.5 crore rupees and commendation certificate. Her coaches Mandeep and Kuldeep were also presented a cheque of 10 lakh rupees each. New World Wealth Report 2016 released. India stood at 7th position. The United States topped the list with total individual wealth held at $48,900 billion. China stood second in the ranking with total individual wealth of $17,400 billion. Japan stood at third in the list with a total individual wealth of $15,100 billion. India's total individual wealth is $5.6 trillion. Sania Mirza becomes world number one in ATP Women's Doubles Tennis Rankings. Mirza topped the list after teaming up with Barbora Strykova of Czech Republic. She recently ended her partnership with Martina Hingis after 3 Grand Slam victories. In the recent rankings, Hingis was figured at the second spot. Hingis is 945 points behind Sania Mirza's 11,260 points. Forbes releases 6th annual list of the world's most innovative companies 2016. It ranked companies using an algorithm to measure investor enthusiasm. Tesla Motors topped the list for the second consecutive year. Salesforce stands at the second position in the list. Regeneron Pharmaceuticals grab the third spot. Indian companies include Asian Paints, Hindustan Unilever, TCS, among others. Abhinav Bindra to head NRAI Review Committee on Rio debacle. It will examine the causes behind shooting, not scoring any medals at the Rio. It will also recommend steps to ensure that this is not repeated in future Olympics. Other members include Manisha Malhotra, Rajiv Bhatia, and 2 journalists. It has been directed to submit the report with a maximum period of 4 weeks. Union Cabinet approves introduction of Surrogacy Regulation Bill 2016. It will regulate surrogacy in India by establishing National Surrogacy Board at the central level. It will also establish state surrogacy boards and appropriate authorities in the states. All infertile Indian married couples who want to avail ethical surrogacy will be benefited. The rights of surrogate mother and children born out of surrogacy will be protected. Union government launches Sugamya Pustakalay and e-library for persons with print disabilities. Sugamya Pustakalay is an online platform to make accessible content to print disabled people. It houses more than 2 lakh books in diverse subjects and languages and multiple accessible formats. The e-library was created by Department of Empowerment of Persons with Disabilities, Divyangana. For more on current affairs, log on to jagranjosh.com.